But it's by his grace and mercy that he allowed this. He said he would add to you.
Yes, Lord.
For this offering, Lord God. We pray, Father God, that we would take it and use it for your kingdom, Lord God. For the building of your kingdom, Lord God. Bless each and every one that give, Lord God. And bless those that didn't, Lord, but have a desire to give. We pray that the next time give an experience that they will give unto you, Lord God. For it's in Jesus' name, Lord, we pray. Amen and amen.
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 Right now, we're going to turn it over to the pastor, man.
Amen. Amen. Once again, good morning, noon to everybody.
Good morning.
I hope everybody is feeling good and ready for a word, because there is a word
Amen.
From the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
There's truly a word from the Lord this morning when I woke up feeling good, you know. Like I tell people, I do not take this lightly.
Amen.
I take this as a privilege that God is allowing me. All I can say is me. That I ran from him and ran from him, and he gave me a second chance. Announcements this morning. Bible study will start Monday, March the 3rd at 7:30 p.m. at the First Lady in our house, 611 East Allen. If you don't know how to get there and you want to be there, get with one of us or the deacon or trustee. We will give you information on how to get there. Happy birthdays. Are there any March birthdays in here?
Amen.
Stand up. Stand up. Stand up.
Amen.
Stand up.
Amen.
What's your name?
Amen.
When is your birthday?
March
12th. March
12th. I'm Bert Wilson.
When is your birthday?
March 27th.
March 27th. Pastor Gene A. McCoy Jr. March 6th. Woo-hoo! Yes, yes. What are we going to do, y'all? We're going to sing happy birthday. So someone lead us out. I led the last one. This is my month now. Go ahead, baby.
Happy birthday to you.
Announce y'all missed my birthday, which was when? Last week.
Hey,
that's
we
all right.
Sing.
Did y'all sing?
You wasn't here. Yeah. We sung.
I wasn't here.
No, you wasn't.
Yeah, I was.
You here when we sung the February birthdays?
Yes, we was, but that, we done it last Sunday also.
No, he was here on
February. February 24th, y'all remember that?
Yeah.
Did nobody sing that song?
Prayer list. We're going to keep Brother Reginald Kern in our prayers.
Amen.
Jonathan McCorkle and his family.
Amen.
And all other sick and shut in.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Now, it's preaching time, y'all.
Amen. Amen.
It is preaching time. This is a time that, like I said, I don't take lightly. And every time
Amen.
I preach, like I get a feeling down on the inside, like I'm talking about God.
Amen.
Yes.
And that's the
yes.
best one you can be under.
Uh-huh.
So for those of you who have your Bibles, turn with me to 2 Timothy, the 4th chapter.
Amen.
If you don't have a Bible, no pastor's going to say it. Go out and get a Bible. Do not get the NIV version.
No, no, no.
Get the King James Version,
Amen.
Please. The NIV, they're trying to take God out of the Bible.
Yes, they are.
They're taking his name completely out of the Bible.
That's right.
Get the KJV, King James Version.
That's right.
Please. Please, if you have that stand, please. 2 Timothy, the 4th chapter, beginning at the 1st verse. And for the time of sake, I was going to do the whole chapter, but I will start at the 6th verse. Amen?
Amen.
Anybody need more time? 2 Timothy. 4th chapter, beginning at the 6th verse. Everybody got it?
Amen.
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 Beginning at the 6th verse. For I am now ready to be offered, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Henceforth, on, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteousness judge, shall give me at that day. And not to me only, but to all them also that love his appearing. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord.
Amen.
Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you for allowing me to stand before your people, Lord.
Uh-huh.
You could have chose anybody else, Lord, to give the name of Second Chance Baptist Ministry, Lord, but you gave it to me, Lord.
Yes.
Lord, I say thank you.
Thank you.
For trusting me to give your word unto the people. Not only to the people, Lord, but also to me, Lord. For the word is for me as well. Lord, now I ask that you humble Gene Jr. And you come in and rest, rule, and abide, Lord.
Yes, yes.
You touch my tongue with the coal, Lord, like you've done the prophet, Lord. And let your word be true and bold, Lord. Let it go out, cut the sin to the left and to the right, Lord.
Uh-huh.
That we may have to go through the narrow strait, Lord, just to get to you, Lord.
Yes, yes.
Let our hands be upon the plow, Heavenly Father, that we don't look back, Lord.
Uh-huh.
That we will always keep you in remembrance, Lord, for this is your day, Heavenly Father.
Yes.
The day that you said, y'all shall reverence me on this day. Now, Heavenly Father, I ask that you come in here, Lord, and show out, Heavenly Father.
Yeah, yeah.
Touch the hearts, Lord, and the minds, Lord.
Yeah. Yes.
Open up the ears, Lord, that we may not only hear the word, but be doers of the word, Heavenly Father.
Yes.
Open up our eyes, Lord, that we may take care of our house before we go live in somebody else's house.
Uh-huh.
Now, Heavenly Father, I ask that you come in here, Lord, and you touch your servant, Lord.
Yes.
In Jesus Christ's name I pray, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Now, if y'all go back and y'all read about Saul, before Saul became Paul, he had to go through some things.
Yes, he did.
For Saul had to realize that it wasn't about him.
Uh-huh.
Just like we had to realize that it's not about us.
Amen.
So everybody know the story of how Saul was on his beast.
Uh-huh.
In other words, he was on his horse for little ones who don't understand the beast.
Uh-huh.
And when Saul was going into the city of Damascus, the Lord shined upon Saul's eyes, but he spoke to Saul.
Uh-huh.
And said, Saul, Saul, why are you doing this to me? In other words, the Lord was asking Saul, what have I done to you that you want to chastise and beat and kill my children? So Saul had to realize once again that it wasn't about him. And if I can use for a topic this morning, I am not ready to run my course.
Amen.
I am not ready to run my course.
Uh-huh.
And in your private time, when you have time, go back and read the story of Saul before he was transferred over into Paul. Saul was a very intelligent man.
Uh-huh.
He came from a rich family.
Amen.
So Paul not only had money, he had his family was already known because in order to get up to the governor and to the emperor, your family had to be known.
Uh-huh.
So that lets me know when Saul had got the paper to go do what he wanted to do against the Christians, his family was known because of his education. Mm-hmm. But now the education that Saul had now. Just like God has shown me, I got a plan. I got a plan for everybody in here. Mm-hmm. What you think you're doing is for your good, it's really for your bad. Because if you're running that wrong race, and you think you're going to end up in heaven, you're going to hell.
Amen.
But God said, I got a plan.
Yes.
But are you willing to follow the plan that I have set for you? Now remember, God is the architect of everything and everybody.
Yes.
For he knew us before. He knew us in the womb before our parents knew that we was in there. God did not make anything wrong. Everything God made, he made right. So when Saul first got this thing, he thought he was doing it good. He went to the governor, and the governor gave him a decree. Whoever and wherever you see Christian, man, woman, boy, or girl, you have a right to do whatever you feel. If you want to put them in prison, you put them in prison. If you want to beat them in the streets, you beat them in the streets. If you wanted to kill him, Saul had a right to kill whomever he pleased. But God had a plan.
Amen.
He had a plan for Saul. But Saul did not know that. Saul thought he was a big man. But really, in stature, Saul was a little man. He was little. But with that decree, Saul had so much power that he really thought that he was a god himself. Mm-hmm. Now imagine if you can walk into someone's house without even knocking on the door. Because you thought they was helping a Christian thing. Like somebody could walk into that door right now. Because we in here serving God. That's a privilege we got.
That's right.
Saul could take every last one of us in here.
That's right.
And do it whatever he pleased.
Amen.
Because of that decree he got from the governor.
Uh-huh.
Now go back and say now, you don't go to the governor unless the governor knows you.
That's right.
And your family.
That's right.
Which is, if you think about it, back then, what he thought he was doing was right, it was really wrong.
Uh-huh.
Which is why I'm here to tell you, I have a course to run.
Amen.
You have a course to run.
That's right.
And when that course is going to start, which side are you going to be on?
Amen.
So while I was reading this, and it crossed my mind, as you are indeed therefore before God, the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the quick and the dead. Mm-hmm. So which means he's going to judge you literally.
That's right.
Then when you die, the trumpet sounds, he's going to judge you again.
That's right.
Because he's judging the quick,
uh-huh,
and he's judging the dead.
That's right.
And his appearance and his kingdom. Mm-hmm. Preach the word. Be instant in season and out of season.
Amen.
Reprove, rebuke. Exhort all long-suffering and darkness. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine.
That's right.
But after their own lust,
uh-huh,
shall they heat themselves and teach them, having itching ears.
Uh-huh.
Now, if you go on and you look on the day, what happened? What just happened in Arizona? The governor was trying to make a law,
uh-huh,
about gays.
That's right.
And it's not right to be gay.
Uh-huh.
I don't care what no one says or how you say it.
That's right.
For the word of God said is abomination unto your soul.
That's right.
When she was getting ready to sign it in the law, the NFL gave her a phone call.
Amen.
If you sign that in the law, we're going to take the NFL and go somewhere else.
Amen.
That's her doing her job by the word of God.
Uh-huh.
But because she got approached by the NFL and the gay and lesbian community, she vetoed her own law.
Uh-huh.
Before she even put it into law.
Uh-huh.
Something she's going to have to answer for. Yes, sir.
Yes, she is.
Yes, she is.
Amen.
For the word of God said, do not go after your own lust.
That's right.
Because it is wrong.
Uh-huh.
You're turning yourself over to a reprobated mind.
That's right.
They're like a dog lay down a bone, he'll go back and pick up that bone.
Uh-huh.
You do not do that. That is wrong within the eyesight of God. And then I read it, I said, Lord, where you going with this? You got a race to run, Pastor.
Uh-huh.
You promised to run this race for me if I open that door.
Uh-huh.
No matter hell, high water, storm come by, you said you were going to run this race for me.
Amen.
And this race is meant to be run.
Uh-huh.
And they shall turn away their ears from the truth.
Uh-huh.
And shall turn to fables. Which means as long as God giving me breath and a second chance about the door, chance has a door to open,
amen,
the truth is going to come forth.
Amen.
So if the truth is not what you're looking for and you want a sugar cane, you're in the wrong place.
Amen.
I'm not sugarcoating no word for nobody.
Amen.
I'm not here to pat you on the back.
Amen.
I'm not here to put a smile on your face.
Amen.
I'm here to let you know that you ought to fear God.
Amen.
And you ought to know that God's word is true.
Right.
If God says so, so be it.
That's right.
And if God is for you,
that's right,
who can be against you?
That's right.
Which is why I had to be like Joshua. When he was standing under the tree,
uh-huh,
and he looked up and he saw somebody hold a sword, the first thing Joshua did, he reached out his sword and said, are you friend or foe?
Uh-huh.
And the man said, put away your sword, for I am the captain of the guard.
Uh-huh. Yes,
and
yes,
that's the kind of man I want to be talking to.
Yeah, yeah.
I want a friend that's,
yeah,
going to be by my side.
Amen.
I want somebody who's going to walk with me.
Amen.
And not talk about me.
Amen.
I want to be like Joshua. I want to know I got,
yes,
God behind,
yes,
me. Or I can lean this way and God,
uh-huh,
right here. I can lean this,
yeah,
way,
yeah,
and God right here. And I know I can look that way and God will lead,
yeah,
me all the way,
yeah,
through.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't need no two-timey friend.
Amen.
I don't need two-timey get away from me.
Amen.
But stand your ground. Plant your feet and let's,
uh-huh,
walk this walk with God together. Let's walk this walk and be on one,
yeah,
accord,
yeah,
with Jesus,
yeah,
Christ.
Yeah.
Well, as I read you, when he said, preach in season and out of season, even when I don't want to preach, I know I got to get up here and preach,
yeah,
the word.
Yeah.
Even if you don't want to hear it, if I got to preach to that silver ball right here, guess,
amen,
what? I'm going to be here speaking to the,
yeah,
silver ball till,
yeah,
the ball starts shaking.
Yeah, yeah.
It don't matter to me.
Yeah,
that's,
yeah,
the promise.
Amen.
I'm in the
house.
And that promise is going to be held true.
Yeah, yeah.
Just like Paul. When Paul knew he was called,
uh-huh,
Paul gave up what he was doing.
That's right.
And when he,
right,
first started, just like me, nobody believed that God,
uh-huh,
had called me.
Uh-huh.
And Paul had to prove himself,
yes, sir,
over and over and over,
over
again,
and
that he was the truth in the word of God.
Yeah.
And I know God called me to preach this.
Say it, preach, preach.
No matter how water,
say it,
Stephen, or whoever, I'm going to preach this word to God called me home.
Amen.
And when Paul said it was time to go home, he said, I got my ticket,
yeah,
and I'm ready to ride.
Yeah.
I want to get on the glory train.
Yeah.
I want to go to Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
I'm telling y'all now, I got my ticket.
Yeah.
I'm ready to be fast.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't matter.
Preach.
I'm
preach.
Ready to be fast. And I'm ready to go. And I know my way.
Yeah.
And I'm ready to go to Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
I don't care.
Yeah.
I do not care.
Yeah.
Okay.
Preach. Preach.
Learn.
Yes.
God is the pilot.
Yes, he is.
Jesus is the co-pilot.
That's right.
I'm just a passenger on
that's
this
right.
ride.
That's right.
But I know I got my ticket.
Uh-huh.
And it's been stamped.
Yeah.
Not by man.
Amen.
Not by me.
Amen.
But it's been stamped by Jehovah's
yes,
down.
Yes,
the one who provided all this for me.
Uh-huh. Yes.
And
yes.
Thank God for that ticket.
Thank
yeah.
you.
If you haven't got your ticket,
thank you.
It's not too late to get your ticket.
Amen.
All you got to do is submit.
Yes,
and say God is the true living God.
Yes,
he died and was rose again.
Yes,
but
yes.
On the third day, couldn't God
yes.
away.
Yes.
On the third day, yes. God, he rose with our power.
Yes.
To let you know that everything is all right.
Yes.
And you do have a right to the tree of life.
Yes,
you do. Oh, good God Almighty, y'all.
Yes,
thank
yes.
you, Jesus.
Yes.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
That's
if you don't have your ticket, I clear you and get your ticket.
Yeah.
But there's only one way you can get your ticket.
That's right.
You got to go down the Roman road.
That's right.
You got to confess with your mouth.
That's right.
That Jesus Christ is your Lord and
that's
Savior.
Right.
Yes, yes.
That Jesus Christ died.
Yes, sir.
But he rose again.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
They might have stretched them wide out.
Uh-huh.
They might have thought they put him in the grave, but grave did couldn't hold him.
Amen.
It could not hold him down.
Amen.
So y'all get into the word.
Amen.
The word is a good word.
Yes, it is.
It is a loving word.
Yes, it
and
is.
I thank God for this.
Amen.
I thank God for this.
Yes,
I
yes.
am now ready to run my course.
Uh-huh.
But when that course is over,
yeah.
Good God Almighty, I stand before God.
Welcome.
And I say, God, here is my ticket.
Yeah.
Here is my ticket. Lord, I ran that race. I ran it for Satan when I ran it. And when you called me when I was in jail, Lord, I ran this race. Here is my ticket, Lord.
Yeah.
And everything
yeah.
I want to hear him say, enter in.
Yes.
Enter in. Well done, my
yes.
servant.
Yes, sir.
Enter in, for your race is now over.
Yes.
Here is your key.
Yeah.
Go on down to Hallelujah Lane.
Yeah.
Go on down to Glory Road.
Yeah.
Take your mansion.
Yeah.
Open your door.
Uh-huh.
And you'll celebrate.
Yeah.
Till you can't celebrate no more.
Yeah.
You go get your boy.
Yeah.
Boy, I'm telling y'all. Woo. Woo, Lord have
yeah.
mercy. It's a good feeling.
Yes, yes.
You got to feel before God. And then when he put that crown on you for all your good deeds, you get a crown on top of a crown.
Yeah.
You get another blessing. So your blessings don't stop here.
Amen.
They still keep going when
Amen.
You get to heaven.
Yes, yes.
Thank God Almighty. Yes, Lord. Oh, Lord, I thank you.
Yes.
Just like your Paul said.
Yeah.
Oh, oh, just like your Paul said. For I am now ready to be offered.
Ready.
And the time of my departure is in hand. Paul knew his time was up.
Yeah.
And he was writing this letter to Timothy. He was telling Timothy was in a young age.
Mm-hmm.
He knew Timothy was going to have to go through some things.
Yeah.
He knew Timothy was going to have to suffer
yeah.
for the word of God.
Yeah.
And y'all think my life is easy?
Uh-huh.
Y'all think what I'm going through is easy? Ask my wife. I know I make good money, but it's like a hole in the bottom of my hand. Y'all think it's easy running this race?
Yeah.
And then when I hear, now don't take this wrong, when I hear that the congregation has a pocket full of money, and I asked my wife, I said, oh, Lord, why me? And she had to let me know who God taking you through so you can preach to somebody else what you going through.
Amen.
So this race, Paul will let Timothy know that his hard time is going to come.
Yeah.
It's going to come.
Yes,
because
right.
you say, Lord, Lord, and you stand behind this pulpit, don't mean you got a bed of roses.
Amen.
You're going to have to stumble on some thorns.
Yeah.
To let them thorns know that I'm still going to run
yes,
this race. I may get tired.
Yeah.
I may get weak.
Uh-huh.
I may get weary.
Yeah.
And I may not want to do this no more.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
I know we're in season.
Amen.
And I know we're out of season.
Yes. Yeah.
I gotta keep the promise.
Yes. Say it.
God gave a promise to me.
Say it.
I know I got to run this race.
Yes. Yes.
Long suffering.
Yeah.
I know I got to run this race.
Yeah. Yeah.
Whether I want to run it or not.
Yeah.
I know I got to be faithful to God.
Yeah.
Because God has been faithful
yeah.
to me.
Yeah. Say
I
it.
Know
yeah.
I got to be true to God. God has been true to me.
Uh-huh.
I can't talk to nobody else, but get your ticket.
Amen.
And get on this ride.
Amen.
Don't miss out when that trumpet blow.
Amen.
Don't miss out.
Amen.
Don't miss out.
Amen.
Don't miss out when that trumpet blow.
Yeah.
Don't
yeah.
do that. Don't do that.
Uh-huh.
Because you don't want to be left behind.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Twice. It's going to be harder to make it than the first time.
That's right.
You're going to want to hear the word of God.
Uh-huh.
And it ain't going to be there.
That's right.
You're going to want to die.
That's right.
And can't die.
That's right.
You're going to want to find your loved ones.
Yeah.
And your loved ones are going to be gone.
That's right.
And you're going to be looking around and saying, where did he close that? Why did he close empty? Why did the man in his car? Because
Amen.
And when that woman vetoed her own bill, I started praying right there at work.
Amen.
I prayed right there at work.
Amen.
I said, you have no idea what you just done.
Amen.
Because if one state do it, other states are going to fall behind.
That's right.
Because you got bullied by the NFL.
That's right.
Because you thought you were going to lose millions and millions of dollars. But in reality, you got a chance to lose your soul.
That's right.
Because you went against the word of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I am not ready to run my course.
Are
you ready to run your course?
Amen.
Are you ready to run your course? But when you start running your course, are you man or woman enough to finish your course? Has God gave you a second chance to run your course?
That's right.
Has God allowed you wake up to the promise that you made to God to run your course? And has God given me this? And I told my wife this morning, the event that's happened this week, when you hear this topic, now I know what you like. I told Deacon McCorkle, every time you give me a topic, y'all know I got so many of them. But every time he give me a topic, something always brings it to light. And I thank God for that ability.
Amen.
I really do. I thank God for the gifts that he's given not only me, but to everyone in here.
Amen.
Are you willing to run your course? When you run that course, that means gifts going to come. You're not going to understand your gifts.
Amen.
You got to ask God to show you what them gifts mean.
That's right.
But during that time, when you stay faithful to God, but when you waver, once you put your hands on that plow, ain't no use of looking back.
Amen.
Just like you told Lot, once you get out of Sodom and Gomorrah,
when
you start hearing all this destruction, don't look back. Don't look back.
Amen.
Keep your eyes straight. Go straight to where you promised me you was going to go.
That's right.
Which means if you get on this race, go where you promised God you was going to go.
That's right.
Because if you look back, like Lot's wife, y'all know the story.
Oh, yeah.
Look back if you want to. While you're looking back and you're driving a car, what seems to happen? You seem to wait. One way or another. Okay, if you got your hands on the plow and you got God guiding you, you're supposed to look straight at him at all times. Let that go. Let that go. Let God do what God does.
Amen.
And watch what happens.
I'm
here to tell you, I'm still waiting.
Amen.
To watch what happens. I'm still waiting on the God that I love.
Amen.
And I've come to call him Yahweh. If you don't know what Yahweh means, that's his first name.
That's right.
That's his true name.
We
call him everything else.
Yep.
But his name is Yahweh. That is his name. That I learned in college.
Amen.
True name of God. That's what the Israelites called him for. Anybody else. Anybody else. That is him. That's who I love. I tell y'all everything. I love God.
Amen.
I like it. I love my daddy. Love my wife. Love my sisters and my brothers. But I'm never going to love them back the way I love God.
Amen.
Nobody. Everybody in here, if there's anything I can do for you, you know I do it for you. Amen. Go back and read this lesson about how Saul became Paul. But during this book, he wrote this letter to Timothy to let Timothy know that even though your greatest beginning is starting, the worst is going to come to you.
Amen.
Come to you. That's what I got out of this right here. My beginning is just starting. I got to get over there. As I told my wife, there's demon hunting. That he's trying to set before me.
That's right.
That's right.
I cannot go back behind that demon hunt.
That's right.
Amen.
I got to cross that hump.
That's right.
In other words, I don't ask God to let this mountain pass by me. I tell him, give me this mountain. Let me get to the top of this mountain. Because it may be hard, because God, I'm going to thank you for this one right here. It may be hard going up that mountain. But once you get to the top.
That's right.
Now, you can't feel that breeze that's on the backside of that mountain. But once you get to the top of that mountain and you feel that breeze, then you start going down that mountain. And you're on the better side of that mountain.
All right.
Good God Almighty, somebody should have cut that.
Amen. I got it.
Amen.
I got it.
Somebody should have cut that one right there.
Every
mountain. ain't meant to be made easy.
That's right.
His mouth don't have a road on it.
That's right.
Sometimes you got to break a fingernail.
Uh-huh.
Break a piece of skin.
Uh-huh.
See some blood.
Uh-huh.
But once you get on the other side of that mouth, then all that everything start coming to you. Then you wonder around, how did I get this and how did I get that? That's because you climbed that mountain.
Yep.
You got over that mountain.
Uh-huh.
And someone tried to put in front of you.
Amen.
So don't worry about that mountain. Ask God to give you that mountain. And watch what happens. No. As I close, I'm running my race. I don't want to race alone.
Amen.
Run your race.
Amen.
That God has given you. Finish your race. And let him know when that glory train comes, and you hear that conductor say, all aboard, and you ain't ashamed to get on it, then when that horn sound, whoo, whoo, and you know you're going to heaven, and you know you're standing on the right side, not on the left side, because the left side, I'm telling you now, you're standing on the left side, and you're standing in front of a white, great throne, you better well go ahead and kiss it.
Amen.
That ain't Jesus, that's the word of God. If you're standing in front of that white throne, you better well go and look over there, because they about to throw you in there. Ain't no getting out of that one.
Amen.
That's in Revelations.
Amen.
Go ahead and read it.
Right.
I'm telling y'all the honest to God truth, man.
It is.
If you standing on that side of the white throne and you see that book already open, you may well go ahead and start hollering.
Amen.
Because there ain't no getting out of that one.
Amen.
At all. At all.
That's right.
Let God stamp your ticket today.
Yes. Yes.
Let him stamp your ticket today.
Yes.
Please. Let us stand. We're not gonna close. We're not gonna end service. We're gonna stand. So we have a communion. Stand,
amen.
Please.
Amen.
The doors of the church are now open.
Amen.
If there's anyone that would like to join a Second Chance Baptist Ministry,
amen.
Now is your opportunity.
Amen.
Now is your opportunity
amen.
To join
amen.
A Second Chance Baptist Ministry.
Amen.
Will we have once? Amen.
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 Come on,
amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.